Hey yo, make sure y'all turn the beat up in the headphones, man. About to get at these niggas, dog. It's the type of shit that I've been waiting to get on, nigga. You feel me? Let me do my thing, dog. Fall apart. Don't hate on me because I'm Hummer in a brand new car. Who would agree why I live like a movie star? What the fact that I really fuck with movie stars? This is real, like when these niggas go see the lights, take a franchise and see yourself losing, like when they rule compile. Haters don't make me diss on the mic. Kids are at night, sleep rock and feeling and sending off hills, got the blood on the mic.
This record is with assaulting prison guards and staff members, spitting on them, throwing hot coffee on them, threatening to kill them. Your heart really goes out to the people that have to work with Mr. Manson, that they have to put up with this type of conduct. He also has, in his past, in Vacaville, he was in possession of LSD. When he was transferred from Vacaville to San Quentin, they found a hacksaw blade concealed in the insole of his shoe. And he also, when he was at Vacaville, had escape plans that they caught him with. Now that's just things that happened before his last hearing. Since his last hearing, of course, he's threatened to murder one of the guards. He's threatened staff members. He assaulted the report said non-prisoner, and I'm not sure exactly who that was, but he shouldn't have assaulted anybody. He was trafficking in narcotics in possession of a stabbing instrument. Mr. Manson, after they would finish their dinners at Spahn Ranch, would preach to his followers. And one of the things he would tell them is that there are no laws. There's no right or wrong, and it's okay to commit murder. Now, the fact that Mr. Manson is not following the regulations in prison is understandable because he doesn't believe that there are any laws. He is a law unto himself. He will do whatever he wants, whenever he wants.